weaving our way over and through 30 and 40 foot pressure ridges.
Doute parce que lorsque vous êtes pionnier. Les motoneiges Ski-Doo.
Every group has its leader.
Paradigms are often just taken for granted, a certain way of doing things. When we come up with a new paradigm, we change for the better, and the other one becomes obsolete. If you see somebody else doing it, then you'll start doing it this way because it's more efficient. But some will never question it because they just follow.
Was I expecting to be something fully different that the market will, you know, absorb and say, yes, we want to ride it? Not at the beginning, let's be honest. But over time, when you get to understand what's behind it, well, yeah, there was something there.
Ski-Doo says it's the revolution, and it really is, with the future of snowmobiling.
I remember Jean-Guy telling me we've hired a young, brilliant engineer under the name of Bruno Giroir.
Let me start from the beginning of the idea of REV. So I never rode snowmobiles before, so my first reaction that the driving position was not good to go through the bumps. In fact, the snowmobile felt so heavy that my body action couldn't have a large impact on the vehicle behavior.
On l'appelait la meule, ou le premier prototype. Là, on voit Bruno assis dessus pour montrer, pour voir une image de qu'est-ce qu'on peut faire, pas rien qu'une image, mais de quoi tangible qu'on peut montrer.
The driver, it's part of the machine. Typically, people are working to improve the components and to improve the vehicle. But we had in mind also to improve the efficiency of the driver.
He's in fifth, but oh, Morgan trying to move on Tucker. Tucker and Morgan.
So I said that I believe we would need to have the feet under our body to be able to stand up, absorb better the bump, and have more leverage.
Mon rôle, moi, c'était de concevoir, de réaliser l'idée. Là, on part d'un véhicule existant.
It's going to pay off right here. So Blair Morgan takes the Pro Open final. Tucker Hibbert crosses in second.
I was still in school, and I knew about the story of the creation of this new REV generation, this new snowmobile generation. I didn't know who they were, but I knew the name of Bruno Giroir and Bertolt Fecteau, knowing that they have created a new generation of snowmobile.
When I first saw it, for me it was flabbergasting because it was the new thing. I want to say kind of an exhilarating design, you know, styling, I should say.
I was really excited. Surprised, not really. We worked hard to convince people that it was a good project. Most of the people were against this project, not understanding the benefits.
Ben, c'est sûr que la position de conduite, c'est fier, mais beaucoup le châssis pyramidal.
We moved the engine backward as far as we can. We moved the steering by about 12 inches and installed a column on top and in front of the engine. We also raised the seat and brought it forward by about 12 inches.
Ce type de châssis-là, il permet d'être plus rigide en, pas deux fois, en cinq fois et six fois plus rigide en torsion. Puis là, ça permettait de calibrer les suspensions beaucoup plus facilement. Puis c'était pas plus pesant, puis c'était six fois plus rigide. La mécanique, il expliquait les premiers monochocs, puis il expliquait beaucoup la théorie de centralisation des masses. Fait, puis là, je voyais l'évolution des motocross, puis des motos en général, de sport, de course aussi, c'était comme ça. Fait, là, il dit, la motoneige est encore restée en arrière depuis 30 ans. Là, fait, c'est pas... faut que ça change.
Typically, the process to go from a concept to a prototype to production is going to be a minimum of 3 years. So these guys were working on it in advance of that. And at that time, you saw guys like Blair Morgan on the racetrack who just revolutionized racing completely.
I think it was almost perfect timing. It was probably the height of the snowcross ever was. You know, we were in the X Games, we were doing all these big events everywhere. It was on ESPN. And then this came out, and yeah, just threw everyone upside down, I think.
Blur's stand-up style, everybody looked at first and kind of went, what is this guy up to? At the same time, this was validation for what was already in process at Ski-Doo in the R&D departments, and it probably helped fast forward it a little bit by saying, look, we see these two coming together.
In the first 1 second that I seen it, it looked so radically different than anything else. Like, I knew immediately, without even opening the hood or riding it or anything, I knew immediately that was gonna change snowmobiling.
This machine changes the rules on how you ride and how we race.
Make no mistake,
the REV rocks.
Make no mistake,
this REV rocks.
The REV rocks.
It was just it was an alignment of the stars. It was unbelievable how it all came together at one time.
Blair Morgan was our first racer that basically from the point he put his butt on the seat, he started winning every single race.
Well, obviously it changed the whole industry instantly overnight. And it shows in our racing, you know, we won the last four championships in pro class and basically sweeping podiums every weekend. So it's just the innovation that all the engineers and the whole Ski-Doo program.
Racing has always been part of the development process. At every generation of the REV, we involve riders in early stage in order to ride with them, test with them, because for the racing world, there is only one target, is to be the first.
The REV has been able to prove to the organization that when you innovate for a purpose and when you're customer focused and you're trying to do the right things for the consumer and you're simplifying people's lives, this pays off.
The REV Gen 5 platform is the first platform where we have two dedicated body work. We were able to bring a stability and a capacity to ride in even more technical terrain. So far, the Gen 5 is just the perfect machine. So the main challenge from now will be to beat it.
That's the way the company started. You know, creating the first snowmobile, the first autoneige, and the first Sea-Doo. That's part of the DNA of the RP.
You know, you have something. But nobody could have planned that we would be number one for 20 years in a row, thanks to the REV.
C'est une belle histoire, c'est une grosse histoire aussi.
We didn't give up. You know, even if most of the people didn't believe in it, we continued and we keep on, and finally it proves that we were right. And I'm also proud because not only it brought Ski-Doo as the leading brand, but you know, it also affects all the market. Everybody has to react to REV.
It's kind of art and science. It's a mix of art and science. And I think at BRP we're quite good at doing that.
When the REV was born, after that it was easier to launch other things. It's a key milestone that enabled us to bring new projects to life that were just as paradigm shifting as the REV.